Francis Crick's adapter hypothesis, the missing link between transcription and translation. So what does all of that mean? We need some background information before we can answer that question. Let's start with the central dogma of genetic information transfer. The information in DNA leads to mRNA via transcription, then protein is produced from mRNA by translation. Our investigation lies in the details of translation, but first let's take a closer look at mRNA. mRNA or messenger RNA begins as pre-mRNA and is edited to become mature mRNA. The most critical steps of editing includes the removal of introns, the addition of a 5' cap, which serves as a bonding site for the ribosome, and the addition of a 3' poly-A tail, which helps with attachment to the ribosome. Ribosomes are critically important as they are the location of translation. In a simplified view, ribosomes are complexes composed of rRNA and proteins and consist of a small and large subunit. The ribosomal unit binds to the 5' end of the mRNA. Inside the ribosome, there are three sites, E, P, and A. But how does this complex build the polypeptide chain? In the 1950s, some scientists thought that the mRNA codons could directly interact with amino acids. However, others, and Francis Crick, did not believe that the nucleic acids or nucleotides of mRNA could differentiate between the amino acids, particularly the ones that are very similar. He proposed that there is likely an adapter that provided the link between the codons of the mRNA and the amino acids for which they coded. He suggested that this link likely contains nucleotides and enzymes. Crick's hypothesis had effectively predicted the existence of tRNA. Transfer RNA is composed of an amino acid on its 3' end and an anticodon on its 5' end. The anticodon is complementary and antiparallel to the codons of mRNA. Importantly, an enzyme called aminoacyl tRNA synthetase charges the tRNA with the appropriate amino acid. Crick referred to the then unknown tRNA as an adapter molecule. An adapter connects two things that would otherwise be incompatible or prone to error. Describing tRNA as an adapter is fitting, as it is the missing link in adding an amino acid using base pairing rules. So when considering tRNA, what could go wrong? If the tRNA were to be charged with the incorrect amino acid due to an error in the enzyme, aminoacyl synthetase, the consequences could be catastrophic to the survival of the organism. Consider sickle cell anemia, which is due to a single point mutation. Valine is added to hemoglobin rather than glutamic acid. Imagine now if one or more tRNAs were carrying and adding the wrong amino acids to multiple proteins in the organism. This would likely lead to a complete change in biological processes that may be fatal or, in the very least, a source of significant mutation. Enzymes, cellular structure, and a cascade of other elements would be affected. The proper function of tRNA is critical to cell success.